episode 2805, How Can You Reduce Your Stress?
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. I hope you're having a fabulous start to your week. I can't believe we're already midweek. It's Wellness Wednesday, and I want you to think about your health. In order for you to do what you want to do, you got to feel good, right? I mean, I spent the weekend with my grandbaby in the hospital. The worst thing there is being sick. So, how can you not be sick? How can you reduce your stress? For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and to sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. So the question is this: how can you reduce your stress and increase your calm? We all need it, don't we? I mean, come on. Dr. Jay Winner says, if you want a relaxed body, you can do it by relaxing your mind. If you want a relaxed mind, relax your body. Stress contributes to many medical problems, including heart disease, obesity, headaches, not to mention the toll it takes on your emotional well-being. But why don't we slow down in order to speed up? Think about that. Busyness still seems to be a badge of honor. And when feeling accomplished becomes the exclamation point of success, there lies a danger that repeats itself. That repetition can lead to further damaging your health and well-being. So what if you could be a better listener for your family and in your personal and professional life? What if you could be happier and more content? What if you could handle challenges differently, giving you permission to be in control? What if you could be successful without the assumption that busyness is the answer? How could that change your life? When stress is prolonged over a period of time without the resolution of calm, it can induce physical and emotional challenges. Your body is positioned in the fight or flight response, accelerating your epinephrine and increasing cortisol, which compromises your immune system. It doesn't work as well, right? Your body is breaking down. If you don't take care of your vehicle, if you don't have oil changes, if you don't get your tires rotated, right? That's all, if you want to think about it, all part of care of a vehicle. It breaks down over time. So do our bodies. If we're not taking care of our bodies, we break down. Think back to the last time you were sick. Usually you can connect the dots that stress was present. And with stress, what? It leads to so many health conditions. And unfortunately, they're linked to many: heart disease, IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, high blood pressure. You got migraine and tension headaches, esophageal reflux, ouch, psoriasis, fibromyalgia. What about obesity? Oh, come on. Acne, depression, blood sugar control in diabetes, hypertension, eczema, infertility, and even premature aging. You're not going to find the fountain of youth when you got stress. And there's much more. Those are just to name a few. But you get the point that stress contributes to all areas of your health or lack thereof, right? It is a factor in how healthy you are. So when you go to your doctor, do you actually talk about your stress management? We don't. We talk about the symptoms of what we're feeling, what we're putting our body under, which is stress. Now, some things, yes, you got to look at from, you know, a medical, physical only point of view. But what if you could do some things to your life to reduce the stress? What if you could live a better life without the added stress, or at least learning how to bring calm in your life? What would that look like? How would that feel? Do you think you would wake up differently? Well, you got to induce calm in your life. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Induce calm, C-A-L-M, in your life. Now, calm comes in all shapes and sizes, and it's specific to you. Some people can manage stress better than others, but don't look side to side, right? Because guess what? Comparison is a stress factor too. Why is it that everything has to be so stressful? It's just stressing me out, right? Let's be real about life. Let's look at what we have. Let's look at our facts, analyze and own our feelings so then we can also move on and make changes accordingly. That's where the transformation happens. But you got to get to the transition. That's where you're tweaking stuff, right? There is, though, I want you to keep this in mind, because stress isn't all bad. There is some stress that is good. But you got to find that balance for your life, how you're wired. And that takes time. And that takes intentionality. So let's break it down. Induce calm, C-A-L-M, in your life. Number one, claim your day. You do this when you create a routine of rest. We know how important sleep is. We know how important rest is. Just sitting down to catch your breath and seeing what's around you, right? It changes things. Don't be tempted to scroll because you can rush your internal comparison clock. Just think about that for a moment. You sit down going, I'm gonna take a break. And you go to Facebook or Instagram and you're just scrolling. And you're like, oh wow, that kitchen's beautiful. I hate my kitchen. And you look over at your kitchen because you're sitting in your chair and you're like, gosh darn it, I really should be doing something. And then you start feeling guilty that you're sitting down. And then you start playing in your mind and you're like, oh, wow, I really feel bad. And you get up. What happened to rest? No more. What happened to stress? Oh, lots more, right? Claim your day. Create a routine of rest. The idea is not to speed up. You want to slow down in order to speed up. So you've got to balance that. You got to have sleep because you won't be refreshed for the start of your day. You heal. Your body heals. It detoxifies when you sleep. If you're not sleeping, you're not healing. If you're not sleeping, you're not detoxifying. And if you've got all those toxins built up in your body, what is also building up? Stress. Do you see where stress is every day? It's everywhere. It's in the nooks and crannies, and you got to eliminate it. So we're working on this, right? The calm. Claim your day. Create a routine of rest. Number two, A, accelerate your control. This comes from abdominal breathing, also known as diaphragmatic breathing. This stimulates the parasympathetic nervous system, which allows you to relax. What did Dr. Winter say, right? If you want to relax the body, you've got to relax the mind. And if you want to relax the mind, you've got to relax the body. It goes hand in hand. So pay close attention to each breath, right? When you breathe in, hold it 2, 3, 4, 5. If you can hold it longer, count to 10 and then release it. On the second breath in, I want you to focus on the feeling, actually the air moving through your body. When you exhale, what does that feel like? Do your shoulders go down? You want them to. You want them to relax. You want to feel as if all the air is going out of your body to where you are a shirt on a hanger. You're just very nicely draped. Your body is so relaxed. You are so connected, right? Your mind connected to your body connected to your mind. Claim your day. Create a routine of rest. Accelerates your control, abdominal breathing. Number three, L, lead with joy. That means you got to limit your yes. You don't have to be the hero for everyone. You got to balance what you do in your everyday. And that means you can't have everything done on your to-do list. That means you can't go and do everything at your child's school. That means you can't be everything to your husband. That means you have got to sit down and say, what are my priorities in this season of life? And yes, that means it happens often. You have got to revisit this. If you want to have calm in your life, you got to come back and revisit it because your life changes every single day. Now, let me tell you this, okay? There's hope. You're probably like, I don't have got time for this. I'm too, what? You know it. You're going to say the big B word, busy. I'm too busy. Stop wearing that badge of honor. It's not getting you anywhere. Slow down to speed up. As you practice this, I promise you, it gets quicker. it gets faster. So you don't have to sit there and feel like you're spending 30 minutes on a breathing technique. You can do it automatically because you've practiced it. Now, is there a little bit of time of learning? Of course there is. But in this calm, you already have some of it. You're just going to refine it. You're going to make it better for you. And as you do it, then pretty soon, you can do things almost in just a few seconds versus minutes to hours, okay? And you can make those shifts, but you got to start. And that's the problem. We say we want to do it, but we really don't do it. And so therefore, stress is higher, calm is lower. And we really want to reverse that and make our calm higher and our stress lower. So lead with joy. Limit your yes. And finally, number four, M, magnify your influence. It's all about how to mind your thoughts. Patiently live in the moment. See what is there to see. Feel what is there to feel. Hear what is there to hear. Taste what is there to taste. Smell what is there to smell. Right now we're having a lot of work done on the house, some by choice and other by force. And so we got the forced renovations happening because of the water inside of the house. But on the outside of the house, I am doing some renovations to our gutters. So another form of water, but we are managing it because we've got some oopsies in our gutters. Some of them just don't hang right. They don't drain where the downspouts are. And so I made the command decision, all new gutters. On top of that, we have beautiful trees around us. Guess what's coming up? What season are we in? Fall. What happens during fall? All the leaves come down off the trees. There are thousands upon thousands of leaves that all end up, not just on my lawn, but in half of my gutters on my home. There are times that I am literally cleaning out the gutters every week because there are so many leaves falling. And I'm like, this is ridiculous. I think I get all the neighbors' leaves too. Just the way the wind blows, how it circles around our home, you know, all of these little just nuances, it all ends up either on our lawn or in our gutters. So I just said, enough is enough. So I go outside and the guys are working on the gutters. You know, it could be driving me crazy. My mess is on the inside of the house. The mess is on the outside of the house. There is no calm right now. But guess what? There actually is. Because I go outside and I hear their screwdriver and I'm like, wow, that means progress. My gutters are going to be finished. I'm having the top put on them, this beautiful metal top that has holes in them. So I no longer have to worry about leaves being in my gutters, which means what? I don't have to be up there every single week. Our leaves are already starting to fall. And I'm sitting here going, huh, what a relief. Now I could be stressing out. So much noise, I'm recording so much noise. But I'm not, because that noise means progress. I love the color. The gutters that were up there from the original owners, I don't know what they did to them. I think some of them are spray painted, honestly. Yeah, I kid you not. But now our gutters are gorgeous. They're not spray painted. They're dyed that color with a coating on them. And guess what? I get a warranty. I could choose to be stressed, but instead I take in the moment. I patiently live out the moment. It's beautiful. My house now is edged with this beautiful chocolate brown, a Tuscan brown that just screams, I got you. I'm going to collect the water and you don't have to worry about it in your house. You don't have to worry about the leaves anymore. I am taking care of you. Mind your thoughts. Focus on the moment. Don't lead your moments with your to-do list. Don't lead your moments with your stress. Don't lead your moments with the whole idea that you got to be everybody's hero. Hone in on the one. The color of the gutters. The gorgeousness of how they just shape my house. The excitement that I don't have to be on the ladder anymore. And yes, I'm kind of done with the screwdriver and the noise. You know? But I'm all right because it's progress. How are you inducing calm in your life? Where do you fall short? And remember, look at it from a factual point of view, not the feelings. You want to go with all facts. And then say, okay, this is what I'm focusing on today. Guess what? Last night, I had to go to bed. I left a few things undone because I knew in order to claim my day for today, I had to create a routine of rest. So I went to bed. I left a few things undone. And guess what? How did I wake up this morning? Not so stressed. I was excited. I was delighted, actually, that I was ready for the day, being able to spend it with you. So where in your life can you induce calm? Where do you need to claim your day, accelerate your control, lead with joy, or magnify your influence? Let me tell you, we all need stress reduction. It's a matter of life and death. And I don't want you to be on the latter side of death. It's about living. Living with intention so you can live your legacy today. Master today to impact tomorrow. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.